Hey everyone, John Enner here from School of Trade. Today we're going to be taking a look at a wave pattern long here on the Dow. Only got a partial fill there. Need to wait for it to fill that last contract. But looking at taking our first target off at 17,759, and then the final target coming off at it's 266 to get that front run in there a little bit. And 66, there we go. Okay, so the way that this trade is just kind of setting up in general is we had this big rotation off the lows, and that was after a really, really strong push from the sellers. And on that next pullback, they just completely fell apart and reversed back up. So we're seeing the buyers coming back into this market. And because of that, we're looking for long reasons to bring this price back up to the overall channel, not the channel, the overall range highs all the way up here. Now, we do have some other larger swing highs before then. We do have over here at 17,795. That's a big one right here. So I'm more looking to kind of wait for that level than anything else. But we're seeing that big rotation off the lows, and we're seeing the sellers completely fall apart. So there's nothing telling us that really they're going to push back down to the lows, at least not yet if they do plan on doing so. So because of that, we're just playing it as is, and we see the buyers stepping in, so we're hopping on along with them for a last chance wave pattern long. So we're in long at 17,751 for contracts, taking two off at 17,59, that's eight ticks, and then taking two more off up above that at 17,766 for 15 more. So we're taking two off at each one, so it's 16 and another 30. So it's 46 ticks total if we get them all filled. $5 a tick means it's $230. So this market is a little bit cheaper because it's only $5 a tick, but that also means that you don't have to put as much risk on the table. So it's an awesome alternative for newer traders or folks who don't have, you know, a massive trade account that they're coming into the market with. It's just a way that you can kind of get in gear with everything else. Now, these deeper pullbacks that we're seeing right now, you can see we pulled into a last chance wave. This is a pretty deep pullback prior over here. We're seeing the sellers still trying to come in, even though it doesn't look like they're going to be successful. That attempt still gets it to push pretty deep down. But notice one big thing, these swings aren't being broken, right? This one was, but that was the only one. We haven't broken below this one. We haven't broken below that one. We're not breaking below this one. We're not seeing the sellers have enough conviction to even break those prior swings, or at least enough to really make a difference. So because of that, our stop down here at 17,741, when we push up, if we get that first target hit at 759, it's still anticipated that the sellers are going to try to come in and push it down again. So because of that, I want to play it a little bit safer than moving my stop to break even, because there's a good likelihood that we're just going to get stopped out. So instead of going to break even immediately, what we're going to do is wait for the market to get its fill, push above the highs, and we're going to kind of ratchet below these swings as we go up instead, slowly and gradually locking out the risk as we go. It does mean that we have to take on a little bit of extra risk at the beginning, but outside of that, it's just a safer way to approach this type of market that we're seeing currently right now on the Dow. So we're long at 17,751. We're a little bit early on the day. It's not even 9 o'clock yet. So it's, you know, not a huge surprise to see this take a little bit of time. But given the fact that it's not even 9 yet, we've actually seen quite a bit of price action so far. We started out the morning pushing all the way up to 17,802, and we got hammered all the way down to 17,693. So honestly, with that knowledge, it's kind of anticipated that today's just going to be a really wide range type day. It doesn't look like they're trying to push down. And if you were looking to trade this as a larger wave pattern to the downside, you can see they tried pushing out of it and they completely failed. So even the larger wave pattern isn't supporting a move down right now, which adds quite a bit of emphasis to what we're looking for. So I'm just looking for prices to rotate back up to the highs, whether that happens now or whether that happens in the next 2 hours. I don't know yet, but we've got our targets in place. We've got our stops in place. Everything's ready to go. We've got a game plan for this type of market sentiment. We're going to try to keep our stops back a little bit to give the market a buffer to go. But outside of that, we're just waiting for that first target. So we'll be back in a little bit. We came close. The buyers tried to get it up there. We got up to 57, two ticks away from 59. So give it a little bit of time, see if we can get that target filled. All right, we're coming one tick away from our target, and we get that target filled. So now that we've got that target filled, this is what we were talking about, where I don't necessarily want to go straight to break even because I'm just asking for trouble there. But we did have this little minor swing that showed up right there, so I'm going to utilize that as my stop, and we're just going to go underneath that to 45. So even though we're still floating a stop on the trade, the stop now went from minus 10 to only minus 6. So even if we do get stopped out, we took 8 off at the first target, so we're only going to give back 12 of the 16, so we still maintain a profitable position, even if it doesn't go kind of as we intended to. But we got that target taken off at 8 ticks. Now we're just looking for that little bit of continuation to push up to 17,766. And the way that this is looking is starting to get almost a little bit stronger. We're starting to see those buyers really not even allow it to go down underneath this cloud here. So I'm half tempted just to split this target here at 17,766 and look for a larger target up to 17,744 or so. And I think based on what we're seeing right now, that's what I'm going to do. So 17,774, we're going to go to 73 just to front run that a little bit, split these targets up, and try to see if we can get a little bit more profit out of this rotation. So right now, if we can get that push up, we took 2 off at 8 already. We've got 1 off looking for at 15, and then the final one coming off at 22 if we can get that one. So an extra couple ticks definitely won't hurt at all. It'll be 16, 15, and 22. So now we're looking at 53 possible, just 265. Every little bit matters when it comes to this, and the way that the market sentiment is setting up, it looks like we're consolidating before a possible push, and that's kind of the way that I'm going to play it. So again, our stop is below that last swing, and we're just looking to see if price wants to continue back up. But we got that first target taken out. Once we can really start breaking through these highs, especially once we get this next target filled, you do have the option of going to break even. I think given the day type, knowing what we're kind of seeing and expecting, I'm just going to trail up along with this movement here underneath those swings and see if we can stay in it long enough to get that 17,773. By the time we get up to that point anyway, our stop's going to be really close to break even, if not above anyway. So it's not a huge deal doing it that way, but just so everyone's on the same page. So looking for the upside here, and we're seeing the exact reason why I didn't want to go to break even. We would have been stopped out here. So looking for that target at 17,766. Stop is now only at minus 6. So we'll give it a little bit more time, see if we can push up to that 66 level. All right, we're testing our target, and there we got it filled. So we saw kind of exactly what we were expecting on this movement, where it's getting a little bit choppy. The sellers are really trying to push this thing off of these highs and take this a little bit lower. Our stop is now locked up to 17,747. We've got our 15-tick target taken out. If you took everything there, that's perfectly fine. I'm looking to leave 4 ticks of risk on the table yet, but we've got 2 off at 8, so we've got 16 and another 15, so we're sitting in a really good position so far. Just looking for that little bit of extra push here up to 17,773. This overall movement, this is what we were kind of looking at, where we're failing to push low. We double bottom, can't push lower, can't push lower, can't push lower. You can see the buyers really slapping this thing around. So because of that, I'm definitely going to give it the room it needs to get this trade going. But again, you could take everything at 15 and just call it a good trade. Overall, I'm looking to get that push up to 17,773, and we'll see if we can get that push up. It might take a little bit of time to get there. We do have the open around the corner in about 13 minutes or so, 9:30, and it might wait until that happens to get this thing going. So we'll kind of play it by ear, but our stop's in place. We're only risking 4 ticks on the trade and already have a decent chunk of profit locked in, so we'll give it some time, see if we can get that 73 tick. All right, we get that strong continuing push up from the buyers, and we smash through, and we finally get that target filled. Definitely took a little bit of time, and it did take just kind of like what we were expecting, where it was going to wait for the open to actually hit. It came really, really close. It pushed up near the target, pulled back a little bit, and then kind of fluctuated around the open hits, and then it rockets back up. We get our target filled up there. Now, again, you do have the option of looking for a possible larger move still, especially with the open fueling our initial kind of thought process that we were going to continue back up to the upside. But overall, everything looking really, really good. We got all of our targets filled. From our entry point here, again, we got, I think it ticked when I tried to highlight that. There we go. So we got 8 ticks on that first target there. That locked in 16, 2 off there. We took 1 off at 15, and then 1 off at that final push higher that gave us 22 ticks. So overall, we're looking at $265 on the trade. And again, at $5 a tick, that's where kind of the funkiness of that pricing comes in. It's 53 ticks overall. So that's going to be the trade. Beautiful movement up. This is kind of exactly what we were expecting, and we played it correctly. We definitely played it according to what it needed to kind of have done. With all the whippiness that we saw, it was much more beneficial to trail long with those swings. And as you see, none of those swings were taken out. So you might still even be in this move right now. But either way, we're out of the trade, $265 richer, and that's going to be the trade. So if you have any questions about it, feel free to send an email to School of Trade. Don't forget to check out our trial at schoolofTrade.com. And as always, we'll catch you next time.